Shakespeare comes to LA in the most modern kind of way. Here to talk about the new adaptation of A Midsummer Night's Dream is Rachael Leigh and director Casey Wilder. Mott, how are you guys?
Good morning. Thanks,
good.
Dana.
Good. Great to see you guys. Thanks for having us.
Oh, we're so happy to have you. And it's interesting because, you know, we know Shakespeare's been done so many different ways.
That's true.
This is a unique way.
Yeah.
But how did you set out to do it differently?
Well, I've lived in LA since I was 23, and it's a city that, like many people who live here, I've had kind of a complex relationship with. But ultimately, now being in my mid-30s, I really love this city, you know, and I wanted to make, and I love the play, and I wanted to make something that was going to allow me to combine those two loves and sort of show how the one could inform the other in a way that hopefully would cause other people who were watching the movie to appreciate both of those things more as well.
Okay, and maybe I'm saying the name wrong. Hermia, is that right?
Hermia.
Hermia. Yeah. Yeah. So I clearly had it right. I'm just kidding. How did you know that Rachael would be perfect for that role?
I'm front row for this.
Yeah. Well, yeah. A lot of it honestly came down to the first time that we met. We had coffee in Larchmont Village, and we were like pretty close to our shooting schedule at that point, so we needed to find someone. There were a couple people that were interested.
That's the best time to get him, Rachael, when you're desperate.
Tell me
right?
about it.
That's the best time. Yeah.
So and, you're saying that you know, perfect because you were desperate? Is
that, if we I, would, were I wouldn't phrase it that way.
Yeah. Wouldn't be the first time.
You need to work on the pitch there.
Hermia in the play is, she's a really magnetic person, you know? She's the one who everyone is drawn to. Uh-huh. And in this reimagining, she's a big movie star, you know? So she needed to be someone who had personal charisma,
right.
You know? And I knew as an actor that Rachael had that because I was obviously familiar with her work. But I didn't know kind of interpersonally that she was also able to kind of do that. And when we met,
I knew within
30 seconds that I'd found my Hermia.
Well, very good.
You can breathe a sigh of relief now, huh?
You did well with that.
Start with an easy one.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Well, before we get too far in, I want to show you a clip of the trailer that we have for you.
Lord, what fool will these mortals be?
Put money in thy purse. 3,000 ducats. Well.
Stand forth, Demetrius. This man hath thy consent to marry my daughter. This man hath bewitched the bosom of my child.
Demetrius loves your fair.
I love thee not, therefore pursue me
my
not.
My heart is true. We should be wooed.
So he was just, Finn Wittrock was just here.
Yeah.
Did you guys recognize the backdrop? It's shot in here in LA. Did any ideas?
Griffith Park.
Close.
We did a couple in Griffith Park, but we did most of our shooting in Topanga State Park.
Oh. Right.
Yeah.
Was there a reason you picked that? Was it
Casey
like
hates
free?
Having cell phone reception.
Oh. Yeah.
Really can't even.
Honestly, it was because part of the reimagining of the story was casting Shakespeare's fairies, woodland spirits, as California hippies, and I think that the pulsing heart of that in LA is in Topanga Canyon, you know. Yeah. And I grew up in Northern California in a town in Mendocino, which was kind of very similar in terms of having this very rich hippie ethos, and I wanted to remind people that. You know, as well as kind of movie stars and big moguls and, you know, all sorts of other characters that exist in LA, there are also these sort of semi-off-the-grid hippies, you know, some of whom live up in Topanga Canyon, so.
Well, you're actually screening the movie at Coldwater Canyon Park.
That's right.
For Tree People's Summer. Can you tell us quickly about that?
Yeah, I'm really excited that we're able to do this with Tree People. They're a great organization. They've been in LA for about 40 years, and they work on urban forestation, which sounds like a contradiction in terms, but when you're familiar with their work, it's actually really fantastic. And they do a fundraising series throughout the summer called Once Upon a Canyon Night, and they do concerts and live comedy and dance performances and all sorts of things. And we're doing a screening this Sunday as part of that series.
That's perfect. Thank you guys so much. It was so good to see you guys. A Midsummer Night's Dream is screening this Sunday, August 26th, at Tree People's Outdoor Amphitheater. Thank you guys. So good to see you. You're such a good sport.
You too.
Thanks, Dana.
Thank you.